Say another student is in jail accused of shooting that victim several times during an argument.
Yeah, the shooting did not happen on the university campus. Danielle Newsom died from gunshot wounds to her head and chest. The 22-year-old was a student from Natchez. The sheriff's department says Ebony White, who is accused of the shooting, is being questioned at the Claiborne County Jail, but no charges have been filed. 16 WAPT's Joseph Pleasant joins us now live at the Stallings Trailer Park in Lorman, where the shooting happened. Joseph.
Brad, we just talked to the chief deputy of the Claiborne County Sheriff's Office, and he told us that White is under arrest, but she's not charged yet because they're still investigating. He says they can arrest and hold someone on pending charges. He says he's not sure exactly what they're going to charge her with. In fact, they were just out here a few minutes ago looking for bullet casings to continue that investigation. At that time, I asked if it could be possible that this shooting was in self-defense. He said he couldn't answer that. Once again, that's a part of the investigation that's ongoing. Now, we want to tell you, these two women were neighbors. Newsom, the woman who died, lived in this trailer right here. Right across the street is where White lived there. Now, the sheriff is saying this is all the result of an ongoing argument between the two women. White accused Newsom of nearly running over her son as he got off the school bus one day. Now, that sparked an ongoing feud between the women. It came to a head this morning when the sheriff says that Newsom went to White's home to confront her. An argument started, and that's when the sheriff says White opened fire. Now, obviously, the news of this shooting is shocking neighbors as well as a student who knew Newsom.
I mean, she's a real, real cool, laid-back person, you know what I'm saying? Very cool, laid-back person, you know what I'm saying? Very friendly, very vocal, and, you know, just she's just a cool, down-to-earth, more down-to-earth person, you know, so.
It was sad, especially in this community, because that don't go on in this community too much.
Now, this morning, sheriff's officials told us White's family came to the scene after the shooting. The sheriff isn't sure where White's son is now, but he says the child was not home when the shooting occurred. Now, this afternoon, Alcorn State University released this statement. The death of Ms. Newsom is a matter of great sorrow for the entire Alcorn family. We offer her family and friends our prayers, support, and deepest sympathy. Back out here live. On campus this afternoon, Alcorn students, faculty, and staff, there were counselors made available for them on campus. Reporting live from Norman, Joseph Pleasant, 16 WAPT News.
All right, thank you, Joseph. Again, one student is dead and another is accused of being the shooter, but no charges have been filed.